Nagoya is one of the most visited destinations in Japan. Its main airport, the Chubu Centrair International Airport, is the 8th busiest in the country, used by over 11 million travelers per year. However, many who visit Nagoya stay in Nagoya. Sure, this bustling city has a lot to offer. Vibrant shopping centers, unforgettable food, and an iconic castle, just to name a few. But most travelers overlook the fact that Nagoya is also the main gateway to one of the most breathtaking regions of Japan. Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Josh. And in this video, we're sharing with you 10 of the best destinations you can visit from Nagoya. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos. Shirakawa-go. This idyllic village in Ono District in Gifu looks like it came straight out of a holiday greeting card. But there's more to this hamlet than appearances. It is also a UNESCO World Heritage Site featuring traditional gassho zukuri farmhouses, some of which are over 250 years old. Although the village is fantastic any time of the year, it is most magical in winter, when snow caps the farmhouses. But if you're around the area in the month of October, don't miss the Doburoku Festival. Don't leave without having a meal at Irori, the village's most popular restaurant serving traditional Japanese meal. Order a set meal with hoba miso, composed of tofu, miso paste, cooked on a magnolia leaf. To get there from Nagoya, just head to the Meitetsu Bus Center where you can take the Gifu bus on Shirakawago Express Line. Get off at Shirakawago bus stop. Travel time is 2 hours and 53 minutes. Takayama. Not too far away from Shirakawago, Takayama is well known for its well-preserved centuries-old buildings and streets. Takayama literally means tall mountain, which is suiting because it's surrounded by Japan's Northern Alps. This seclusion allows the city to develop a unique charm that highlights its culture and history. Among the key attractions in the area is Takayama Jinja, an Edo period government building used by the Tokugawa shogunate to collect taxes and conduct court trials. Inside, you'll get to see the offices, kitchen, gardens, and even the torture chamber, all intact. Just a short walk from the Jinja are Takayama's famous old streets, flanked mainly by well-preserved merchant houses. Today, most of the buildings are occupied by stores selling souvenirs, sake, and curious collectibles. Most of these shops offer free taste, ensuring a good buy each time. Also located in Takayama City is Shinotaka Ropeway, the only ropeway in Japan with double-decker gondolas. But more than the cable cars, the site itself is stunning. From the lookout, you'll enjoy a panoramic view of the surrounding peaks. If you have more time, try their onsen. This area is notable for having over 100 outdoor hot baths. To get here from Nagoya, just make your way to Meitetsu Bus Center and take the bus to Takayama Hida Bus Center. Travel time is 2 hours and 40 minutes. Nagashima Resort. The Nagashima Resort is perhaps Mie Prefecture's most popular vacation spot. Located in Kuwana City, it is often mistaken to be in Nagoya by foreign tourists because it is easily accessible from here. The property is composed of 4 major facilities: a theme park, a hot springs complex, a giant outlet mall, and a flower park called Nabana no Sato. Nabana no Sato is perhaps the most stunning flower park I have seen in Japan. There are perennial flowers. The begonia garden, sheltered in a giant greenhouse, is captivating year-round, but the outdoor is covered mostly by annual flowers, fostering a different atmosphere according to the season. Yet, the most magical time to visit is October to May, when the park shimmers with massive winter illumination displays. The light tunnels and Mount Fuji illumination show are total crowd magnets because they're just so breathtakingly beautiful. Iga Ninja City. Also located in Mie Prefecture, Iga City can be reached from Nagoya after an hour and a half drive or a 2.5 hour journey on public transportation. Most of us are very familiar with ninja. We've seen it in movies, anime series, and many other forms of entertainment. But for the longest time here in Iga City's Ueno area, ninjutsu is a way of life. Iga City is widely regarded as the origin of Iga Ryu, one of the two ninja traditions that became well known in Japan. Unlike the samurai, who is often a celebrated warrior, a ninja has to stay low profile because ninjas are spies. The ways of the ninja are showcased at Igariyu Ninja Museum, which was modeled after a real ninja house. From the outside, the museum doesn't look much. It appears just like an ordinary one-story bungalow. But that's the whole point. Ninja houses back in the day must not draw attention. However, when you go inside, it's full of surprises. Inside the house, you'll discover all the tricks that will allow them to hide their assets and escape the house in case of an attack. There are secret doors and hidden rooms, as well as other mind-blowing inventions. The house also has three levels inside, with the top floor often used as a place to produce gunpowder. Beneath the surface is an underground tunnel that has been converted into a museum. You'll find truckloads of information about the ninja life here. They also stage ninja shows on some days. You'll also find images of ninja everywhere, from blockers at the train station to random ninja statues. They also have a ninja-themed train. Ise Shrine. Also located roughly 1.5 hours from Nagoya, Ise Jingu is the holiest and the most sacred site in the Shinto religion. The shrine grounds are so vast, it can easily eat up an entire morning. It's also covered by countless ancient cypress and cedar trees. You'll notice that the lower part of the trunks of these trees are smooth. That's because visitors keep touching and hugging them because doing so is said to grant a long life. Just a short walk from here is Oharaimachi. For most of its history, this small town is the approach to the Ise Grand Shrine, and pilgrims make a stop here for a meal or for an overnight stay after a reflective visit. The most visited part of Oharaimachi is Okage Yokocho, a nostalgic cobblestone street that recreates the atmosphere of an Edo period and Meiji period town. It is lined with various restaurants, food stalls, and souvenir shops. Find a restaurant called Sushi Q and order Tekone Sushi, a dish composed of bonito sashimi marinated in shoyu and served on top of vinegar blended rice. It's a Mie delicacy, so enjoy it while you're here. Gero Onsen. Gero City is another famous onsen destination in Gifu Prefecture. Caught by two rivers, Hide River and Maze River, 90% of the area is covered by forests and mountains, including Mount Ontake, the second highest volcano in Japan. If you're after some peace of mind or you simply wish to relax, this is a great choice for you. I have to say, this is my favorite place in Gifu. Small quiet towns always steal my heart, and Gero did exactly that. Every corner of this small city is so cinematic, every nook romantic. It has that irresistible charisma that I can't put into words. Every Saturday in winter, the government stages a fireworks display best viewed from the bridge straddling Hida River. If you're staying in Nagoya or Takayama and you have a Saturday to spare, make time for Gero. To get here from Nagoya Station, you can take the train to Gero Station. Travel time is around 2 hours. If you're planning to stay overnight in Gero, you can take the daily shuttle bus at Nagoya Station to Gero Station. Hida-Furukawa. I have two words for you. Your name. If it doesn't ring a bell, what have you been doing with your life? Your Name or Kimi no Nawa is a 2016 anime film about a boy from Tokyo and a girl from a fictional town called Itomori, who find themselves swapping bodies mysteriously. This movie was so successful that it became the highest-grossing anime film of all time. What does it have to do with this video? Well, Itomori may be a fictional town, but it was clearly in Gifu Prefecture. It is also widely believed to be modeled after a real place, Hida-Furukawa. The film has given new life into the city, jump-starting its tourism activities. Visitors can see the spots that inspired settings in the movie, but there's more to it than movie references. Furukawa is a tiny old castle town, even smaller than Takayama. But like Takayama, it is mentioned in travel books for its heritage streets and houses and the festival. Don't miss Takumikan Museum, which showcases the history of carpentry in the city. To get here from Nagoya Station, take the limited express Hida train to Hida Furukawa Station. Travel time is 2.5 hours. Gujo Hachiman. The riverside city of Gujo is best known for three things: their drinking water, their summer dance festival, and their food replica industry. When we arrived in Gojo, one of the first things our guide showed us was their waterways. It's remarkable for two reasons: that they still work in the same way as in the 1600s when it was built, and that they remain the primary source of water for locals to this day. That's how clean these canals are and how pristine the water is. Gojo is also famous for their 400-year-old Summer Dance Festival, a massive event attended by hundreds of thousands of people from various parts of Japan. Participants wear kimono and wooden shoes while performing the Bon Odori dance all through the night. The dance is highlighted in Gojo Hachiman Museum, where you can also learn some of the routines performed at the festival. Lastly, you've probably seen realistic replicas displayed in front of restaurants in Japan. That's one of the main products of Gojo. At Sample Village Iwasaki, you can try making food replicas using wax. A staff will be teaching and assisting you through the whole session. Beginners get to create lettuce and tempura samples. It looks complicated, but it was pretty easy if you just follow the instructions closely. Gamagori. One of the key attractions in Aichi Prefecture is Laguna Tenbosch, a massive theme park complex in Gamagori City. Think of it as Aichi's answer to Osaka's Universal Studios and Tokyo's Disneyland, only weirder. Laguna Tenbosch is divided into several zones, including Lagunasia, an amusement park with thrilling rides, Laguna Flower Lagoon, a giant garden featuring beautiful blooms, Laguna Illumination and 3D Mapping, Laguna Spa, featuring hot springs, a festival market, and Henna Hotel, a strange hotel that appears to be run by robot dinosaurs. Henna Hotel, the robot dinosaur hotel is particularly interesting. I first heard about it in an episode of Dark Tourist on Netflix, so I was stoked to be able to see it in person. The hotel isn't really staffless, there are a few human workers involved, but most of the check-in and reception tasks can be done on your own through the assistance of talking electronic Jurassic friends. Also in Gamagori are two fruit-picking farms. Oranges and strawberries are some of the city's top produce. At Orange Park, you can spend some time exploring while picking fruits yourself. You can even eat as many oranges as you want within a set period. Just a short walk from the Orange Park is another farm where you can pick strawberries. Inuyama. Almost every major city in Japan has its own castle. Osaka and Nagoya are two of the most recognizable globally, but they are only reconstructions. The truth is, only 5 castles in Japan are original castles and considered national treasure: Himeji, Hikone, Matsumoto, Kochi, and Inuyama. Of the 5, Inuyama is the oldest, completed in 1440. Inuyama Castle stands next to Kiso River, which separates Gifu and Aichi. From the top of the tower, you can easily see both prefectures and even have a glimpse of the mountains of Nagano. Even the tall buildings of Nagoya are visible from here. The castle towers are built under Oda Nobuyasu, the uncle of Oda Nobunaga, one of the most powerful daimyo in Japanese history. The ownership was then transferred to the Naruse clan, and it remained with them for centuries until 2004, when the rights were turned over to the Education Board of Aichi. We visited in late autumn or early winter, and it was surrounded by colorful foliage. Bright reds and oranges adorned the castle grounds. Not too far away is a picturesque old street overlooked by the castle. That's all for now. If you need more information about traveling to and around Japan, you'll find several comprehensive travel guides on our website, www.theportraveler.net, or check out the links in the description. You can also find us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, and Twitter. Just look for @ThePoorTraveler_L. You may also follow and tune in to The Poor Traveler Podcast on Spotify. See you again next time. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.